Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to add this AmbilVerna color picker dialog in your Android project. So this AmbilVerna is a guy from Indonesia and he has this color picker dialog library on Maven Central, and we can import it using this dependency. So I will copy this dependency. Then I will go to my project. Okay, so here in the project level build.gradle, we have to add Maven Central in repositories and also in all projects, repositories of all projects, we have to add Maven Central. Then in this app level build.gradle, we have to add this dependency and then click on sync now. So when you click on sync now, it will download this library. So your computer must be connected to internet for downloading this library. Now it has downloaded this library and we can use this in our project. So next step is to show the dialog. So this is how the dialog will look like, and it says we have to use this constructor AmbilVerna dialog equal to new AmbilVerna dialog, then it takes the context, then the initial color and this AmbilVerna listener, which contains these two methods on OK and on cancel, and then there is this show method. So let's copy this. Now we go to our project. Here I have activity main.xml, which contains a button, which is button 1, and a text view, which is text view 1. And in main activity, I have defined this button 1 in onCreate and text view 1 in onCreate. And also I have this onClick listener for button 1. So when button 1 is clicked, I will show this color picker dialog. So I will paste the code here. So this is AmbilVerna dialog. We have to import this. So click on this red icon here and click on import class. So when you click on import class, it will automatically import this AmbilVerna dialog here. uq.ambilverna.ambilverna dialog. Next we have to import this. Okay, I'll just shift this to new line. So it has this new AmbilVerna listener, so we have to import this also. Just click this red icon here and click on import class. Now we need an initial color. So here at top I will define an int variable. Initial color. This will be equal to color dot red. So the initial color for this dialog will be red, and we have to close this bracket. You can see that it has not been closed. So after this bracket I will put another closing curly bracket, and then we have to close this bracket also. So here I will put a symbol like this and put a semicolon, and the context will be main activity.this. Okay, and after this, after defining the dialog, we can show the dialog. So next is this OK button click on OK. So in this we can use the color which is selected. So here I will use this color for setting the color of text view 1. Text view 1 dot set text color color. Okay, I have used this int color to set the text of this color. Now suppose if you have to save this color so that it appears as the initial color next time, then you have to set it as initial color is equal to color. So next time when you open this dialog, the initial color will be the color which you used last time. And if you have to save this color in shared preferences, then you have to add shared preferences here. Shared preferences SP, and then in onCreate, define the shared preferences. SP is equal to get shared preferences SP comma mode private. And then we can add this color to shared preferences. So here I will add SP dot edit dot put string. Here I will be putting a string with ID color comma. I will convert this color to a string variable. So here I will add string dot value of color and dot commit. You have to put dot commit at the end. So this will save the color in a string form in shared preferences. And in onCreate method, before this button is clicked, we have to get this color to initial color. So first we will check if sp.getStringColor comma empty dot equals empty. So if the value of color equals empty, then we will do nothing else. When it is not empty, then we will set initial color to the color from shared preferences. So this will be equal to the int form of double dot parse double this thing sp dot get string color, and then just close this. Okay, so this will be saved as the initial color. Now let's check this app. Okay, so here is the app. When I click on pick color, okay, it had already saved it, so that's why it had different color. Now I can select this color, which is red, and the text appears red. When I click this once again, you can see the initial color is red. So suppose if I take blue now, the text becomes blue, and next time the initial color will be blue. So now I will make it green. Okay, and then let's exit the app and open the app once again. So when I click this, you can see that initial color is green. So that's fine this video. Thank you very much for watching this.